Hi guys, newly arrived stuff. It is the first part of Sony broadcast shipment. So it is a battery charger for the electronic news gathering broadcast cameras from Sony. The model number is BC1WD, and it is the most well-made battery charger I have ever seen so far. It works with this big packs of nickel cadmium in P1B, 12 volts at 2.3 ampere hour. So you can see the thing is quite big. You have a LED display here to give you the charge of the last battery here in a detailed status. There is a battery refresh mode you can disable. It discharge the battery before recharging it. And you can see it can host up to 4 batteries with each time a status LED. You can see the size of the thing. On the back you have a pretty serious IEC plug with a securing feature here to prevent the cable being pulled out by error. There is a grounding screw here. Manufacturer plate, serial number is 11567, made in Japan of course. And here is the bottom, you can see the number of screws on this thing, it is quite impressive. So it was very dirty, in fact I did just reassemble it, and I spent quite a few time cleaning it. There were a lot of sticky tape residues. Now it is almost clean, so we have a look at how it works. If I connect it, I have not read the user manual yet, but so first you have this serious switch at the front. So now it is switched on. You can disable the refresh mode. Here there is a tiny LED in the middle, but it is very dim. So if I put the battery this way, we can hear relays clicking, and now it is first checking the battery status, I believe. It takes a few seconds, then it will start the process of discharging it if necessary, and charging. So I guess the complete charge will take some time. There is a fan at the back here to cool the thing, and so here it is. So we will have a look inside, because obviously I will not wait hours for it to do its job. So in fact, when the battery is charged, this indicates the amount of ampere hours you have available in the battery. But for now, it is estimating the battery. So we can hear things happening. And now the light is green here, so probably it is starting to charge it slowly. The LED will flash with different patterns during the charging process, it seems. I need to check the user manual to know exactly what it means. Okay, so we'll have a look inside now. So here are the insides of the charger. First, the IEC socket here. We have very serious noise filtering with gigantic common mode shocks. I have never seen one this big, almost. Quite a serious bridge rectifier here. So under this fan, we have, it seems, the switching mode power supply transformer. We have some power transistors and regulators, and we have one or two power resistors, ceramic power resistors at the bottom here for the battery refreshing feature probably. Here we have the brains with one little brain chip, BDE0 3AB, it is written on this, date code 1993. Here we have some relays, so we can see it seems like each battery has two relays, one regular Matsushita black box here, very common kind of relay. And this one is very interesting, it is very very tiny. Brand is NAIS and it is rated 3 amperes at 200 volts AC or 3 amperes at 30 volts DC. Here at the front we have a panel of the PCB with the LED display on a little chip. Main switch here. Here is the connector for the LEDs on the top part, and here is the connector for the actual batteries. Here you have the PCB with the contacts for the batteries. You can see each one has a fuse and a little disc capacitor. Here are the LEDs for the battery status. Nice diffuse white case on the red and green LEDs. Very very nicely made, as you can see, as you can expect from Sony. By the way, this thing is mounted onto a very serious metal plate with some insulating foam under it and a plastic sheet. Here you have a big grounding screw and a serious grounding wire. Here is the bottom cover. We have information about who made the molding. Kawabe Kosai Company. With yes, date code is November 1993. And you can see, apart from some scratch and sticky tape residues, the plastic parts are in good condition. I spent at least 2 hours rubbing sticky tape residues, but now it is clean and there is no damage. Cover is good. Did take a shower because there was a lot of dust at the bottom of the battery slots. So no choice, I had to put it under the shower. Luckily I have a very powerful shower and it is almost like a pressure washer to get rid of dust. Very nice, you can see it is the same manufacturer. And here is how this plate fits here, this PCB, like so. And the LED, status LED PCB, go down there. The 3 screws, as you can see, each one has its grounding wire connected to the metal frame. Okay, so I will put back this together. I am waiting next week for the matching camera, Sony EVW300. So of course there will be excuse me, video about this, maybe even an unpacking video. It depends if I have time to do the unpacking video or not, and of course tear down of a camera, because it will be quite nice. And it will require a complete cleaning also, by the way. Thanks for watching, bye bye.